Hi, creators. Welcome or welcome back to Academic Phoenix Plus. My name is Monica, and I am your guide to your creative journey. In this video tutorial, we are going to be covering how to create a flag, how to use nCloth, as well as how to create an alpha or transparencies to make the edges look frayed. It's a jam-packed tutorial, so let's go ahead and get started. If you are new to this channel, I post tutorials on a weekly basis. Software includes Maya, ZBrush, Substance Painter, and so much more. So if that is your sort of thing, please consider subscribing. So bring out that creativity, open up that software, and let's go ahead and get started in creating this dynamic flag.
So we're gonna grab a plane.
Yep.
Make it long. Give yourself plenty of mesh. And before I get started with this, if I'm going to texture it, I highly recommend that you guys UV map it right away. So I'm going to go ahead and go to modeling, UV map, planar mapping options, and choose Z. So if I attach some sort of texture and it's all full of wrinkles and stuff like that, it would be way challenging to UV map that than a plain surface. So I went ahead and did that. Let's go ahead and bring it in here. So I want to take a look here. Clearly, it's being connected by something, but we can't see it. So what I'm going to do is basically create this is going to be my asset, but I'm just going to make it really low poly. So I'm going to use that as my passive, and then I can duplicate it and then just kind of bring it together a little bit. All right. So again, I'm going to delete the history, all that stuff. This is going to be my effects and cloth. And this one's going to be my passive. And then I'm going to grab vertices. Shift select that one. Constraint, point to surface. Why don't we just watch it? Let's see, just for fun. Whee! So cool. Okay. Focus. All right. Let's go to vertices here. Shift select this one. Constraint, point to surface. Rewind, play. Now, what's neat about passive colliders is that you can actually animate these. I can actually move this up here and animate this. So for example, I'm going to go ahead and rewind this. I'm going to hit S for animation. And that after the simulation happens, I can actually move this. So again, I hit an S and then I could see the effect. So then I get a bit more of that cloth look and feel. So something like that. It's not exactly like the concept art because it's a little tighter and it's got a lot more wrinkles. But that gives, hopefully that gives you guys an idea. So I might want to rewind this and select this and maybe not go as far. But what I can also do is maybe grab some of these and also constraint. So that's going to give me a few more folds. So I'm going to do the same thing for here. And I might animate this one too, just a little bit. Right, so that kind of gives you an idea of nCloth. Again, it's a little harder to get exactly these number of wrinkles. You could probably sculpt it and everything. I'm going to leave it as that just as an example of nCloth, but I just wanted to demonstrate to you guys what's possible. Once you're happy with it, you can select it, you can duplicate it, and then you can either hide these for now, the simulation, unless, you know, you want more. I'm just going to go ahead and group them and then hide them. It's a similar color to the tree, so I'm just going to add that in there just for the sake of this blocking. And let me see what that looks like in render cam. Panels, render crown, Arnold render. And I'm going to bring this down. It's huge. Let me grab all these rocks and group them. Just want to see how close I am to the reference here. It's like around here. And to be fair, once you have this, you can actually model it. So for example, I could just grab a soft select brush and just kind of whoop. Whoop. Okay, I think that's close to the reference. What I wanted to show you was how to create the ripping effect. So some of us may think that, hey, why don't we just model this? But that would be really, really crazy. So instead, what we're going to do is create a color map, which is the red, and then an alpha map, which would be the transparency. When we talk about alphas, we're not talking about transmission, which is basically glass, right? So if I turn this into glass, right, I can make this look like red glass, pink. So we're not talking about glass. What we're talking about is actually transparency. Transparency is found under geometry, under opacity. So white means that it's solid, and black means that it's transparent. And notice that it doesn't bend the light. It's literally gone. So we can use this to create kind of like cutouts. In our UVs, let's go to UVs. I already UV'd it before I did the dynamics. So now we're just going to export the UV snapshot. Let's browse. Let's go to images. And I'm going to call this flag UV snap. 2048 is a little bit high. I probably will do 2048. A TIFF is fine, and then apply it close. And let's open up Mighty Photoshop. So let me go to my images, and here is my UV snap. And just because I like to see what I'm doing, I usually put a black background, and this is our flag. So what we want to do is create a kind of like a ripped edge around here. As we mentioned before, anything white, again, if you forget, you can always just go into the opacity and see that anything white you see and anything black you don't see. So right now, everything is black. I'm going to call this UV snap. I'm going to lock it because I'm always afraid I'm going to paint over it. And I'm just going to fill this environment with white. Now for ripping, if you guys want to create your own, like let's say you want to make it a little bit painterly, there's a lot of different types of textures out there that you can choose to go in and make it yourself, right? So I'm just going to go in and this isn't great. It's just an example, but hopefully you guys will get the idea. Something like that. And just for fun, let me hide my UV snap. Save as. This is going to be my alpha. And I am going to make it as a Photoshop for now until it's done. So let me go ahead and click OK. Opacity, click on this. Click on File. Click on that little folder. Let's go to images, and here we go. I clearly have a cutout. So to get more realistic cutouts and things like that, the best way to do that is basically, I would say, online. What I was doing was trying to find some sort of rock texture that in textures.com. So you could type in rip and kind of look for it, or, well, here's something that looks somewhat ripped. I'm just trying to look for like a ripped material that I can use as a reference. Ooh, bloody stuff. That's great. This is actually pretty nice. Let me see if I can download it. Okay. So the idea is that I want to use this outline. Now it's got a lot of other junk. So it's going to be interesting to try to paint that out. And to be fair, I probably should be using a solid brush. Let's see if we can select subject. Let's see what it does. Well, actually, I did pretty good. So you can see that it selected that. What I'm trying to do is just get the outline. So I'm going to copy that, paste it in. I do need my UVs, so let me pop that back up. So what's nice about when you use a real material like this, it just looks much better than you painting it. But if you do painterly stuff, then, you know, why not? If you go to layer 3 and you double click here, you can do what's called a color overlay. And I'm choosing white. And I'm going to go ahead and remove the smiley face. So this area remains black and this area remains white. Let me go ahead and save that. Won't let me. So file save as. And then I'll just call this number 2. I'll take a snapshot just because it's funny. And I'm just going to type in number 2. So now that's a lot more realistic. So that's basically the idea behind opacity. To make this one more realistic, what we can do is the roughness is already there. So there is something called a sheen, and we can add a little bit of sheen to it. And that's going to give it a little bit more of a cloth material feel. It's kind of nice. So I'll give it the soft edges. So it makes it look more like, I want to say velvet, but it definitely looks more like material. And I haven't really done any type of material work on it. So if I wanted to, I can call this, let's see, color. Turn that effect off. And I can use, instead of white, I can try using red, and then just make this somewhat transparent like that. So then I get the dirt already there. So let's see what we get from this. So I'll take a snapshot of this just so we can compare. Since I'm already working on the flag, let's go to color, let's go to file, folder, images, flag, color. Looks kind of dark, but let's see what we get. Really dark. All right, let's see. Let's go to raw. And that looks a little better. Not as red, but that's because my texture is not that red. And the reason why is because of the gray underneath it. Let's see if I can increase the exposure. Whoa. I'm trying to see if I can actually change the color here, because sometimes you can. So, for example, there we go. So, that's what I wanted to demonstrate, is that you're not limited to just Photoshop and making all the alterations and things like that. In the file node, it has this thing called color balance, and you can actually manipulate this to kind of give you different colors. So if something's a little too dark, you can use exposure to either lighten it, or you can darken it. So for example, for the color offset, I just changed it to a little bit more red, and then that red kind of appeared. So the last thing I would do for this material is basically a bumpmap. So let me file save this as. This is going to be a BMP, which stands for bump. I would go ahead and create a adjustment layer. Whoops, I'm down here at the bottom. So that it's grayscaled. So I would take this and just desaturate it so that it's gray. And I think it's a little strong, but we'll see what it looks like. So let's save this. And we can find the bump map under geometry. Here's the bump. Click. Let me save. Click. File. Scroll up. And then we can go to images. So we can already see a little noise, but let's see what that looks like. So you can start seeing that before it was very kind of shiny. And now with the bump map, it really started to read a little bit more noisy. So it looks more like material now. Hopefully you guys get the idea of opacity and how awesome it is. And also a little bit of bump mapping, texturing, and stuff like that using a material found in textures.com, which is usually where I get most of my materials.
Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Hopefully you learned a thing or two. If you did, please like and subscribe. That is your message to me, letting me know that you like this content and that you want to see more. Don't forget to share my video. If you know of an artist that needs a little help in creating a flag, then please share my videos. That would be amazing. Don't forget to take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. There you will find free resources such as ebooks, 3D models, and so much more. So take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. Again, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Keep creating, and I will see you next time in the next video tutorial.